We are excited to be here today to talk about how we used AI agents to help the clinical trial process get a lot faster. I'm Scott. I lead our AI innovation team at Genmab. And the only reason I got the time to come here is because my five-year-old was super excited I got to meet ChatGPT in person, because he tells way better stories than Daddy does. So, Sam?
I'm Sam Wagner. Scott, maybe after the talk we can meet Mr. ChatGPT.
Well, I think we should. Yeah. So, Genmab, we are a biotech company. We are an innovation company, but focused on biology. But that culture has permeated, and now Genmab is committed to not only being the best at biology and antibodies, but also to not just adopt AI, but try to push it forward. So this is where our framework comes in to help something we think is really important. The clinical trial process, if for those who don't know, is super long and super expensive, 8 years or more, billions of dollars for one medicine in one disease. Something has to give to scale this. And we think that AI is well positioned to help here. So we're going to tell you a story about how we did this for a very specific use case for document generation, regulatory documents that you have to submit to the government. One of these things you can think of as the patient's story. So for every patient on every trial, you have to for every day that they're on your trial, you have to generate a very specific clinical document that takes a skilled workforce a significant amount of time to triangulate. They have to go to hundreds of different documents or hundreds of different pages of documents, thousands of data points, compile that all together with their skills as clinicians, right? And generate this summary. This is one of many, many documents, by the way. We can go into more if you want. For thousands of patients, this takes significant amount of time. And often it's not just your internal stakeholders and company and data, but it's external partners too that you have to work with. And you know, GPT-4.0 just prompting can't get you that. For a regulatory document, you need to be 100% accurate. 99% is not good enough. So we're going to talk about how our framework, which we call Kelly, can get us that last mile to do this. So we our high-level architecture here sort of explains how, and Sam's going to show you this in a minute, our language model takes in sort of real natural language, the user story of the task, plans out the future in context, knows what step 10 is going to be when it's executing step 1, can self-correct, has a guideline, has a way of evaluating how each step executes and performs, and sort of is able to tailor and customize the plan going forward. Now it takes that, and everything it does, all the tools that it calls in step 1, is the input, is the step 0 of the next step. And we can sort of iterate this kind of ad nauseum, and we show that you can converge on that 100% accuracy that we're looking for. We've also shown, and this is going to be published soon, that it can solve generic problems where you know how to evaluate the solution, but we can go into that later. But I think right now, I'm super excited to hand the floor to Sam to show us Kelly in action. Sam?
Thanks, Scott. All right, so I'm going to kick off Kelly here. As it's loading, what I'm going to show you here is the points that Scott was talking about, which are that we're able to learn the patient as we go along, that it's drafting step by step, section by section, and as it's doing that, it has a retrieval process to get the information that it needs. So the first thing that it does is give us a system message here. The way that we initialize this is that we have a series of prompts specifying the job, right? So the first thing that we do is, and this is a compilation of the job description which you write beforehand. So the first thing that we do is we set up a role and an objective to say that you're gonna draft this particular document. We set some criteria for what the tasks are. So this is a list of tasks that need to be done sequentially. So you can think of this as a checklist, right? So it's gonna complete the first task, then move on to the second, third, and so on. And as it's doing that, if it's not able to do a task, that it's able to solve that. The medical writers and the clinicians give us guidelines to how these things are supposed to be drafted. So that's included in the instructions, in the prompts. We also have some prompt completion mechanics, which is an essential part of Kelly. This is really part of the secret sauce. So what we tell it is that as it progresses, that it needs to tell us what's been completed, what it's working on, and what it's going to work on next. So first thing that happens here is we sent this to this system message to GPT. It responds. It knows that the first thing that it does needs to do here is do a function call for the particular identifier for the clinical trial. And what's interesting here is that any kind of IDs or keys that you retrieve, it's going to stay in context. So you can do any kind of key value pair lookups in your function calls at any time. So we sent that to GPT. It responds. Tells us that the first task has been completed. It's working on task two. Proceed to task two. So it's going to instruct itself the next time that a call is made. So it knows to keep going here. So it does a function call. It retrieves the table here. Those results are appended to the context. So the context keep building up here. Now we have two tasks that are done. So the interesting points here is that it has an evolving narrative here. It tells us what kind of information that it's gleaning from the particular retrievals. And the other part of this, too, is that it knows how this information is going to be used later on. So this is task two right now, and it's telling us later it needs this information for drafting. So it can see ahead to task 10 because all of that information is inside of the system prompt altogether. So just as a reminder, every time that this is done, sent to GPT, the system message comes along with that. So it has that blueprint the entire way. So we're going to skip ahead to where it starts to draft. At this point, it has all of the tables that it needs. So it starts to write. Here's the background section. Here, it writes about day one. And it keeps doing this, keeps writing every section until it's done with that. And it's time to compile it. It's compiled it all together. And one of the reasons that we do that is that we're very accurate when we cut this up into smaller sections that it writes, and it's able to glean all the information that it needs from the context. So here we save that. There is a monitoring agent at the end of the process that confirms that it's been saved. Everything's been done up to that point in sequence like it's supposed to, and then we have a complete draft, which looks like this. All right, back to you, Scott.
Cool. So, as I'm pulling this up, what Sam showed could take hours, but his process takes minutes. And we're talking about thousands of patients on many different trials for many different days, lots of other documents too. And if you think about it, like the ultimate goal here is, if you shave a month off of a trial, let's just say a month, that's literally hundreds or thousands of people that with serious disease that can have access to our drug that would not have been able to because of how serious the disease is. So that's what like gets us up in the morning to come into work, right, is that problem. And if you're interested in working on those problems with us, like QR codes, open source, Kelly as a problem solver, as a document generator, is generic, we think. Also on the right, if you're interested in helping people with serious disease, that's for you. So thank you very much. We've been so excited to be here today. Thank you.